Hello YouTube, this is Chen. I got this robot kit I ordered from banggood.com today. It's pretty cheap and looks like some good stuff inside, so let's take a look. Okay, so nicely packaged. So it comes with our Arduino Uno equivalent, I believe. This is a servo for the ultrasonic sensor, plus screwdriver. USB for Arduino. This looks like the Arduino sensor shield. It must be for the ultrasonic sensor. The ultrasonic sensor itself. Some hardware that's supposed to hold the sensor, and you can use a servo to drive it around. This looks like a motor drive. Arduino Uno equipment. Okay. So I guess that's all the drive wheels and the hulls and bodies of the car. These are some gear motor. One board that holds everything. Got a battery holder for 4A, I guess. That's the connection for the motors. Some little pieces, I guess that's holding the motor in place. There's a third wheel, rocker switch, four of these. These are some encoder part that gonna connect to here, and you can use a sensor to detect the angles it rotated. And a bunch of hardware. Surprisingly, it doesn't come with a manual, so I'm not sure how to put them together, but I'll look it up online and hopefully I'll find something I'll share with you guys. Hello guys, I'm back. After some research, I did find some tutorials online. They are mostly in Chinese, so I guess that's why it's so hard to search for. Luckily, I'm here. So let's start building it. So if you look closely with this board, the holes are not symmetrical, so there might be some reason for that. I don't know yet, but maybe we have to switch side later. So first of step, you can peel off these films, but to make it clear to see on the camera, so I'll just leave them on. Let's do the wheels first. So based on what I found online, you want this yellow dot right here that facing outside. So the way it works is you put this two pin thing across here, you put the wheels on, then find those long screws, or two holes here, just make it all over the other side, and use a nut to fix them. It's a little tricky for the bottom one, because it's like no clearance in there, but it's doable. Okay, so you could put the encoder wheel on, or maybe it's easier for you if you want to attach it before putting the motor on. So these two holes here, I believe, are used for the encoder optical sensor. I'll put the wheel on here. Okay, so this one set done. Let's do the other one. So this will be the bottom, so the car like sit like that. Make sure the yellow dot is on the outside. Okay. Now we need to put this third wheel. So I guess you can put it flush just against the board, but it'll be tilted a little bit. From what I read, you need this standoffs to extend it a little bit. I'll just use this smaller screws. Okay, so now it's pretty flat. Let's screw those on the ground. Okay. And for these guys, I don't know where is the best locations yet, but This looks like a pretty good fit spot for the rocker switch. Probably want to mount it from the bottom. I don't know yet. Okay, maybe we can jump to this servo part. Based on the comment from this product or reviews, a lot of people don't know how to do this part. And I did do some research and figured out it's actually a pan and tilt camera mount, which is kind of cool if you want to put a camera on it, right? It only comes, the kit only comes with one servo, so it's mainly for this ultrasonic sensor to move this way so it can detect any obstacles. Let's put them together. So the way it works is, see, it's a little too far that we mount it this way. And if you look close, there's just enough space for it to fit in it. Make sure it's pretty tight. And put this part here. Okay, it's misaligned, but I guess it's okay. All right, for this part, actually, you can put another servo on. I happen to have one the same size here. So basically, you mount it the other way. Yeah, the other way. So mount it like this, two screws down there, and this pin goes in here, and the servo gear goes to here. Then, you know, you put one of the arms here to connect this part so it could move up and down. Yeah, but for this build, we're really gonna do this part. So after this, we can mount it like this here. So to make it work, we need to use one of the arms. For part two. Okay, we need a clipper. So we got the clip now. The goal is to cut the long arms short so it fits in there. So let's just do it real quick. I mean, it's still pretty fat, so. Let's trim this a little bit more. Hey guys, I realized I made a mistake. I clipped this too much, so it doesn't fit anymore. I mean, none of those little tiny holes fit there for us to clip down with a screw. But anyway, I think it's gonna cause other problem too in the end because you know this head of the screw is gonna stick out. So we'll just use the most powerful tool, my favorite, the hot glue gun. Okay, we'll just put some more around it. Okay, it's nasty, that's okay. And this thing, push it down. Yeah, looks pretty solid to me. All right, now we can put this on and it should rotate like that. The last step, we need to screw this on to this guy here. But it's funny, all the hot glues are stuck there, so bring it down really fast. Should be good now. We probably should play with the angle in the future, so you know this location is centered. Okay. Okay. So for that install, we can put the ultrasonic on. Based on the tutorials I saw, they were using some little this wire thing that usually you can find for cables. Basically, just tie them up like that. But you can use rubber band, I believe. Okay, so let me cross from there. Yeah, just like that. Okay. Thank you. Maybe we can do probably again. Still have to. Here we go, this is our head of our robot. And I found that there are four holes at front, which is here. This is two and this slot that could fit it like that. So we got a bag of screws on the pan tilt head. We'll just use any of these. Oh, forgot to mention, we need to screw it down at some point here, which are this part. So there are two screw holes. Probably should use this. But it's pretty tight because the servo in there. Okay, it's for extra security. Okay. Now we just need to use all these machine screws. Not sure if that's long enough, but I'll take a look. Definitely, it barely stick out, so it potentially could work. Alright, then the next would be battery holders. Arduino and the motor driver. For the sensor board, I definitely just go on top of Arduino, just look for the orientation like that. And this, I didn't find a perfect hole setup yet, but I would imagine one this Arduino port, you just point to the back so we can have all the ports or on the side. This guy's, I don't know. Here, I don't know where you put the battery holders. I mean, you can put it on the bottom, but it could fall off. Let's try that, maybe. Oh, okay. Plenty of space down here. We could route all the wires through this hole. That's not a bad idea. So we can have your rocker switch. It's just like the steps, you can just push them in. Shouldn't be too hard. Okay, looks nice. I mean, I really don't want to put a battery holder on the bottom, in case the batteries fail off. But I guess that's the only way, because this is gonna be too tall and you don't want to expose all the electronics down there. It's definitely taller. So I guess the final layout, it's totally up to you, but something like this or this. And from the resources I found, all the board come with the standoffs. Just like this tiny guys, so the bottom of the PCB is not touching anything metal, to clean it short. But this kit doesn't come with that. I mean, you probably want to find something to insulate. But that's how so far I got. Alright, cool. I'll figure out all the connections and create another video later. Thanks for watching. So if you like this video, please subscribe. And if you have any kit online that you bought and you don't know how to put them together, send me a link. I can look them up for you. And thanks for watching.